Hi dear students, a very warm good morning and welcome to the new episode of English class. In the previous class, we discussed the first part of our third lesson, Brotherhood. The first part of our third lesson, the title of our third lesson is Brotherhood. What is the meaning of Brotherhood? Brotherhood means love between brothers, love and affection between brothers. Sahodaryam, Brotherhood means love and affection among brothers, that is Brotherhood. The story of two brothers are described in this lesson, and the brothers were Prem and Shiv. The two brothers were Prem and Shiv. I write the important things from the previous episode. Prem and Shiv were the brothers, and Shiv, they were living in a small village. They were living in a small village. What is the name of the village? Prempur. The name of the village is Prempur. And where is Prempur? Prempur is in the foothills of Satpura Hills in Madhya Pradesh. Satpura Hills in Madhya Pradesh. Prempur in Satpura Hills. S-A-T-P-U-R. Satpura Hills in Madhya Pradesh. Hills. In Madhya Pradesh, P-R-A-D-E-S-H, Satpura Hills in Madhya Pradesh. Okay, what are the other things we studied? They were very kind and simple. These two brothers loved each other very much, and they were very kind and simple. Their houses were next to each other. They are living in two houses, and their houses were next to each other, and so as their fields, so were their fields. That means their houses were next to each other, and their fields were also next to each other. They were working in the farm field. They were working in their own field. Their fields were also near to each other. Prem is the elder one, and Shiv is the younger one. Prem had a son. Prem considered Shiv as his son. And Prem had two grown up daughters. Grown up daughters. Daughters. And Shiv had two younger sons. Prem had two grown up daughters, and Shiv had two younger sons. And it was the end of the harvesting season. This story took place at the end of the harvesting season. What do you mean by harvest? To take the yield from plants in a single growing season, that is harvest. Harvest means take the yield. Yield means vilava. Take the yield in one single season, in one harvesting season, that is harvest. And it was the end of the harvesting season. The season had been good. It was a good harvesting season. And they were happy. These two brothers, Shiv and Prem, were happy and content. Happy with their crops, and they were content. Content means satisfied, happy and content. The crops had been cut. They cut the crops. Then what did they do? They harvested it, and then they stored it in the barn. Barn means a place where we store our yield or harvest. Barn is a place where we store our harvested crops. And both the heaps of the harvested crops seemed to be equal. Both of them, that means Shiv and Prem, made a heap. Heap means a pile, P-I-L-E, Kuna. They made a heap of heap by their own. That means they both had a heap. Each heap were equal to the other one. Their heaps were equal. But when seeing from a distance, their heaps were looking equal. It was the end of the harvesting season. The season had been good. They were happy and content. The crops had been cut, harvested, and stored. stored in the barn. Both the heaps of the harvested crops seemed to be equal. One day she said to Prem, "Brother, I feel hungry. I think the baby must not be well. That is why Shyama has not brought our lunch." One day the younger one sheep told to Prem, they were working together, they were cropping together, they were harvesting together, and they were eating together, and they were staying at two houses, but that houses were very close to each other and their fields were also close to each other. One day while they were working in the field, Shiv told his brother Prem that, "Brother, I am hungry, I feel hungry. I thought baby must not be well. Baby must be sick today. Sick means not well. Baby must be sick, though, so Shyama couldn't bring lunch for us. Shyama, otherwise, if the baby is well, Shyama will bring lunch. That is their habit. But today Shyama did not bring lunch because baby must not be ill. Baby may not be ill. Must not be well. Their baby must not be well, not ill, well. And that is why Shyama has not brought our lunch. I will go eat and come back, then you can go afterwards. At first I will go eat and come back, then you can go to have your lunch. Please stay here, else the animals and the birds will damage our field. Okay, please stay here, brother. You please stay here. Otherwise, some animals or birds will come and damage our ears. Some animals will come and damage our ears or damage our crops. Okay, then Prem said, "You are right." Then the elder one, who is the elder one? Prem said that, "You are right, brother. You go first and I will look after your keep also. Then you will come. When you come back, I will go to have my lunch." And yes, you are right, go first, you go first, take care of the baby too. Prem had a brotherly affection, not a brotherly affection, a fatherly affection towards Shiva. Prem had a fatherly affection. Prem considered Shiv to be his son and he had a fatherly affection towards Shiv. So he is thinking that he is responsible to look after the wellness or the good condition of the children of Shiv, and he told Shiv to take good care of your son, to take good care of the son, and I will go after you. Then one of us should stay here, otherwise some animals or birds will come and destroy means damage, destroy our ears. Okay, there we stopped in the previous class. I read that part once again. There on the foothills of the Satpura Hills in Madhya Pradesh was a village called Prembo. The villagers lived in peace and harmony. In the village lived two brothers, Prem and Shiv. They loved and cared for each other. Their houses were next to each other. So were their fields. Prem, the elder, had two grown-up daughters who went to school, and Shiv had two sons who were still young. It was the end of the harvesting season. The season had been good, so they were very happy and content. The crops had been cut, harvested, and stored in the barn. Both the heaps of the harvested crops seemed to be equal. One day, she said to Prem, "Brother, I feel hungry. I think the baby must not be well. That is why Shyama has not brought our lunch. I will go eat and come back. You can go afterwards. Please stay here, else the animals and the birds will damage our yield." Prem said, "Yes, you are right. You go first. Take care of the baby too. I will go after you. Then one of us should stay here." Then they were living happily. Both these brothers, Prem and Shiv, were living happily. And we have to look at the other paragraph. Look here. After Shiv had left, Prem thought and that Shiv is like a son to him. That when Shiv go away from there, Prem was sitting there and he is thinking that Shiv is like a son to me. Shiv is like a son to me. Shiv has to take care of two young sons. My brother is suffering a lot. He had to take care of two young sons. His sons were not matured. They were not grown up. He had to look after two young sons. And the younger one keeps falling sick frequently. And the younger one, two sons he had, and the younger one is not sick. But the younger one is falling sick. See, frequently means continuously. Is that the spelling of frequently? F-R-E-2-U-E-N-T-L-Y frequently. What is the meaning of frequently? Continuously. Frequently means continuously. The younger son, that means one of his son, falls ill or falls sick frequently. Continuously he is falling sick. And his medical expenses were also high. So, to be sick, the child needed more medical help. So, the medical expense means cost, chilava, expense. The medical expense, medical spelling, M-E-D-I-C-A-L, medical expense, E-X-P-E-N-C-E-N-S-E, the medical expense were also very high. She is like my son, he had two sons, but he had to spend a lot of money on the treatment of his younger son. There is, his younger son is having sick or is in the habit of falling sick frequently. Frequently means continuously, F-R-E-Q-U-E-N-T-L-Y, frequently. What is the meaning of frequently? So he had to meet the hospital expense, which is very high. The medical expense is also very high. But Shivu will not accept any help from me. He is considering me as his father, and he is not bothering me about anything. He is not bothering me about his worries, and he is not telling me about his worries, and he did not accept any help from me. Accept, the word is accept. Yes, A-C-C-E-P-T, accept. Yes, A-C-C-E-P-T, accept. He did not accept any help from me. He will not accept any help from me. Then Prem came up with an idea. He is thinking for a long time. Prem is sitting there in the field, and he is thinking for a long time. And after thinking for a long time, he got an idea. What was the idea? He got an idea, and he filled two bags of crop from his own heap. What did Prem do? Prem took two bags to fill the crops from his own heap. Two heaps are there. One is the heap of Shiv and the other one is the heap of Prem. Prem took two bags and filled the bag with the crops. From which heap? From his own heap. He took two full sacks of or bags of crop from his own heap. And what did he do? He emptied it. Emptied means he put the crop into the heap of Shiv. He emptied. E-M-E-T-I-E-D. M-T-D-M-P-T-I-P-D, emptied. He emptied two full bags of crops from his own heap into the heap of Shiv. And he felt happy. Then he felt happy. I can help my brother. They how? Without the knowledge of Shiv. Shiv, if Shiv knows that, Shiv will not accept my help. Then without the knowledge of or without the consent of Shiv, Prem is trying to help him. Prem is trying to help him. Okay. Look at the paragraph once again. After Shiv had left, Prem thought that Shiv is like a son to him. After Shiv left from there, Prem thought that, what did Prem think? Prem thought that he is like a son to me. He had to look after, or Shiv has to take care of two young sons, and the younger one keeps falling sick frequently. The younger one keeps falling sick frequently. His hospital or medical expenses were very high. His medical expenses also are also high. But she will not accept any help from me. But she did not accept or will not accept any help from me. Then Prem came up with an idea. After thinking for a long time, Prem got an idea. What was the idea? He filled two bags of crops from his own heap and put it in the other heap. That means put it in the heap of Shiv. He put two bags of crops from his own heap into the heap of Shiv, and he became happy. Then he finds a way to help his brother. Thus he put By putting two bags of crops into Shiv's grave, Prem helped his brother. But the brother did not know that Prem helped me. And unknowingly, without the knowledge of Shiv or without the acceptance of Shiv, he put the two sacks of crops into the heap of Shiv, and then he became happy. I can help my brother. Then he became happy. At that time, Shiv returned and told his tender brother, "You can go now, and for your lunch, I will stay here. Brother, you go now, I will sit here." Then Shiv returned, R-E-T-U-R-N-E. He returned. The next word is returned, R-E-T-U-R-N-E. Returned. Shiv returned from there. Shiv returned after lunch, and he told his brother, "Brother, you please go and have your lunch. I will be here. I will sit here." Shiv returned and told his elder brother, "You can go for your lunch. You can now go for your lunch. I will stay here." After Prem had left, Shiv thought that, "My elder brother has always looked after me like a father." After Shiv go away, sorry, Prem go away from there. After Shiv Prem went away from there, what was Shiv doing? Shiv thought for a while, "He is considering me as a son. I am having a fatherly affection towards him." "He is having a fatherly affection towards me. He looked after me like a father. But he now has two daughters. But he now has two grown up daughters. He is looking after me like a father, and he is now have two daughters, and he has to provide for their education." Provide means give. P-R-O-V-I-D-E. Provide. What is the meaning of provide? Give. Provide good education. E-D-U-C-A-T-I-O-N. Education. E-D-U-C-A-T-I-O-N. Education. What is the spelling of education? E-D-U-C-A-T-I-O-N. He has to provide a good education for his daughters. There may be much expense for that. He has to provide for their education. My children are still young. As far as children are concerned, they did not want more money for their education. Their education amount or expense is very low. But as far as the children above plus 2, that means till plus 2, they need a children's education, need only less money. But more than plus 2, children who are studying more than plus 2, above plus 2, they need a large amount of money. My children are still young. They did not want more money. He needs more than I do. Shiv is thinking that younger brother, Shiv is thinking that my brother needs more money than I. My brother needs more money than I. So he is in need of more money. So what did Shiv do? Shiv did not know that Prem helped him. Prem put two bags of crops into his heap. He unknowingly filled two bags of grains from his own heap. He is not taking from Prem's. He filled two bags from his own heap. He took two bags of crops from his own heap and he emptied it on Prem's heap. The love and affection of these brothers. This is a model you should practice in your home. You should practice in your life also. This is a moral story. The brotherhood, the love and affection among brothers. Nowadays, we are seeing that the brothers are quarreling for their parents' wealth, and the brothers are quarreling for a pinch of land, and the brothers are quarreling for small things. But here, these brothers are not thinking about themselves, they are thinking about the other one. They are thinking about the, or they are caring about, or they are loving each other. They are caring each other, and they are thinking about the other one's welfare. They are thinking about the other one's welfare. Okay, and at first we had seen that Prem filled two bags of crops from his heap and put it into the heap of Shiv. And now, without knowing that, Shiv filled two bags of crops from his own heap and put it in the heap of Prem. Okay, look at the top words of this part. Please listen here. frequently, spelling FREQUENTLY, 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 frequently. Next word, medical, MEDICAL, related to medicine, or related to hospital, medical. The next one, expense, EXPENSE, expense. Next word, accept, ACCEPT, accept. Next word, emptied, EMPTIED, emptied. Next one, return, RETURNED, returned. Next word, provide, 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 provide. Next one, education, EDUCATIO, education. This again is a frequently, the medical, expense, accept, empty, return, provide, education. Okay. I'll read from the today's portion. Please listen. After Shiv had left, Prem thought that Shiv is like a son to him. Shiv has to take care of two young sons, and the younger one keeps falling sick frequently. His medical expenses are also high, but Shiv will not accept any help from me. Then Prem came up with an idea. He filled two bags of the crop from his own heap and emptied it on Shiv's heap. He felt happy. Shiv returned and told his elder brother, You can now go for your lunch and I'll stay here. After Prem had left, Shiv thought that my elder brother has always looked after me like a father, but he has two daughters. He has to provide for their education. My children are still ill. He needs more than I do. So he filled two bags of grains from his own heap and emptied them on Prem's heap. Okay, the next paragraph. When Prem returned, after some day Prem returned to there. After some time having lunch, Prem returned to the air. It took him only a minute to realize. Realize means understand. R-E-A-L-I-Z-E. Realize. R-E-A-L-I-Z-E. Realize means understand. Realized, understood the past tense. It took only 1 minute for Prem. When he looked at the heap of them, he understood that Prem take two bags of food grains from his own heap and put it in the other one, put it into my heap. His eyes filled with tears. It took only 1 minute, only a minute to realize that his heap was back to the original size. Original means old, original. Real. O-R-I-G-I-N-A-L. Original. Spelling O-R-I-G-I-N-A-L. Original. O-R-I-G-I-N-A-L. Original. When Prem returned, it took him only a minute to realize that his heap was back to the original size. He looked at Shiv with tears in his eyes. His eyes filled with tears and happiness. He knows very well that his brother loved him more than anything in the world. His brother loved him more than anything in the world. And his eyes filled with tears, and both of them realized what the other had done. Then both of them understood, then Shiv also understood that my brother put two bags of crops into my heap. I put two bags of crops into his heap. They think only how to help each other. They are thinking about how they can help each other. They are not thinking about their own welfare, but they are thinking about the welfare of their brothers. And they hugged each other and cried. Hugged means tight embrace. Embrace, E-M-B-R-A-C-E, embrace. Hugged, H-U-G-G-E-D. These two brothers, Prem and Shiv, hugged each other. H-U-G-G-E-D. They hugged each other. They hugged and cried. They hugged each other and cried with happiness. They together prayed. Prayed means offered, prayed to God. That means prayed, Prarthichu. They prayed together. P R A Y E D. Prayed. They prayed together. They prayed means they asked to God. What did they pray? May our love for each other always remain the same. Remain means stay. Remain. R E M A I N. Remain. R E M A I N. Remain. What is the meaning of remain? Stay. Then always our love and care for each other remain the same. May God bless you. Bless us. May God bless us to keep this love and affection for the last time of our life. Life came, love and care. You should allow us to love and care each other till the end of our life. May our love for each other always remain the same. Same means keep. We shall stand by each other through the thick and thin. Through the thick and thin means every sufferings. Whenever some sufferings or confusion or any difficulties came in our life, we should be standing united. We should stand united. Then we can face any dangerous situation or difficult situation. We can, God give us the strength to overcome any difficult situations and give us the opportunity to retain or sustain our love and care for each other. Sustain our love and care for each other. Okay, this is a folktale from Madhya Pradesh. This is a folktale. Folktale means folktale. Yes, folktale. Folktale. The tale. Tale means story. T-A-I-L, tale. There is a tale. T-A-I-L. The hind part of animals. Then T-A-L-E, tale. Tale means story. Story. Folk tale. Stories. I read from the very beginning. You please listen. There on the foothills of the Satpuras in Madhya Pradesh was a village called Prembo. The villagers lived in peace and harmony. In the village lived two brothers, Prem and Shiv. They loved and cared for each other. Their houses were next to each other, so were their fields. Prem, the elder, had two grown-up daughters who went to school, and Shiv had two sons who were schooling. It was the end of the harvesting season. The season had been good. They were happy and content. The crops had been cut, harvested, and stored in the barn. Both heaps of the harvested crop seemed to be equal. One day Shiv said to Prem, "Brother, I feel hungry. I think the baby must not be well. That is why Shaima has not brought our lunch. I will go eat and come back. You can go afterwards. Please stay here, else the animals and birds will damage your yield." Prem said, "Yes, you are right. You go first, take care of the baby too. I will go after your return. One of us should stay here." After Shiv had left, Prem thought that Shiv is like a son to him. Shiv has to take care of two young sons, and the younger one keeps falling sick frequently. His hospital expense or medical expense are also very high. But she will not accept any help from me. Then Prem came up with an idea. He filled two bags of crops from his own heap and emptied it on Shiv's head. He felt happy. Shiv returned and told his brother, elder brother, "You can now go for your lunch. I will stay here." After Prem had left, Shiv thought that my elder brother has always looked after me like a father, but he now has two daughters. He has to provide for their education. My children are still young. He needs more than I do. So he filled two bags of grains from his own heap and emptied them on Prem's head. When Prem returned, it took him only a minute to realize that his heap was back to the original size. He looked at Shiv with tears in his eyes. Both of them realized what the other had done. They hugged each other and cried. They together prayed, "May our love for each other always remain the same. We shall stand by each other through the thick and thin." Thick and thin is a usage. Our sufferings and happiness. Means happiness and sorrows. Okay. Next, listen to the top words of this paragraph. Realize. R-E-A-L-I-Z-A. realize. R E A L I Z E realize. And next one original. O R I G I N A L original. Then hugged. H U G G E D hugged. Next one prayed. P R A Y E D prayed. Next one remain. R E M A I N remain. R E M-A-I-N. Okay, now let, I am going to ask you some questions from this previous, from the previous class and today. Okay, who is Prem and Shiv? Who is Prem and Shiv? Prem and Shiv are the two loved brothers. Two brothers who know the value of love and care for each other. Okay, where do they live? They live a village called Prempur in the foothills of the Satpura hills in Madhya Pradesh. And how do the villagers live? The villagers live in harmony and peace. The villagers live in peace and harmony. And what was the condition of the life of these two brothers? These two brothers were living in harmony and they loved and cared for each other more than anything else. Their houses were next to each other and so were their fields. What kind of a season was it? It was a harvesting season and it was a good harvesting season. They cut the crops, then harvested it and then stored it in the barn. Both of them seemed equal. The elder one, Prem, had two grown-up brothers and the younger one, Shiv, had two young sons. One day, while they were working in the field, Shiv told his brother, "Brother, I am feeling hungry. Today I think the child must not be there. My baby must not be well. Otherwise, my wife Shaima will bring our lunch." Okay, then Shiv, "I want to go to home and have my lunch. I will return within a few minutes and you take care of, or you stay here. Otherwise, some animals or birds will come and damage our crops." Prem agreed to that and Prem told him, "You take care of the baby well and you go and have your lunch and then return. I will go after you return." Then Prem stayed in the field and Shiv went to his house. After Shiv went away from the field, what did Prem do? Prem think about Shiv. "Shiv is like a son to me and he had two young sons and he had to look after two young sons and one of the sons, that means the younger one, had a habit of falling sick frequently." Frequently means continuously. Then his medical expenses are also very high. "But he will not accept any help from me. And what can I do?" He think for a moment. And then he got an idea. What did he do? Prem took two bags and filled the bags with the crops from his own heap. And he put that crops into the heap of sheep. And then he became happy. "Thus I can help, or this is the way I can help my brother." When Shiv returned, after some time Shiv returned from the home and he told Prem to go to home and have your lunch. "I will stay here." Prem go to his house and then Shiv sat there and thought for a while. "My brother is looking after me like a father and he has now two daughters. Their educational expense, their expense of education, or their amount of education is very high. He needs more money than I. So I had to do something." He also took, without knowing that Prem put two sides of crop into his heap, he took two bags and filled it with his own crop and emptied it or put it in the heap of Prem. After some day, Prem returned to the field and only with one look he understood that what did Shiv do. Then his eyes filled with tears and he embraced. Then both of them understood that what the other brother did to the other one. Then both of them hugged each other and cried for a moment. Then they prayed to God, they prayed together to God that our love and care will last forever, will ever remain the same. And they think about, they are thinking not about themselves, they are thinking about the brothers. That means Shiva is thinking about Prem and Prem is thinking about Shiva. This is the brotherhood we have to practice. Okay, you should practice the brotherhood of Prem and Shiva. This is the moral of the story. Don't have any enmity among your siblings. If it is a sister or brother, you do not quarrel with them and you share your things with them and you have the mentality to help the other one when they are having a difficult situation. Okay, this will be enough for today. And today let us wind up our class and see you in the next class. Thank you.